quick overview of our presentation. We're going to tell you guys a quick summary, what feminism is, and how feminism is portrayed in AMP throughout the story. So I know the story, we read it back in the beginning of the semester, so I'm just going to refresh your memory with a little summary. So it's about Sammy. He works in the AMP store as a cashier. When three girls came to the store in just their pure bathing suits, and he was fantasizing about them, he was making up names for them, and the girls were just shopping, and when they were about to pay, the manager, Lengo, came and told them that they couldn't be inside the store like that, they had to be wearing more clothes, and then Sammy got upset, and he decided to quit his job. So the main characters would be Sammy, the three girls, Lengo, and Stokesy. So some facts about the story is that the author, John Updike, got inspired by a situation he was in. He saw a girl in a bathing suit in a grocery store, and he decided to write a story about it. He wrote it in 1961, and that's like during the 1960s was a decade for changing women. The second wave feminism was going on, and that's because women wanted more equal working conditions as men.
So the reason we're talking about feminism involved in the story, first let me give you a definition of what feminism is. The belief that man and woman should have equal rights and opportunities. It is an issue that has been going on since the 1940s, and women want the same right as men. They don't want to be seen like just stay at home moms, so they gotta take care of the children. So the feminism movement was going on at the same time the story was published by John Updike in the 1960s. During the time, women were expected to just like marry and have a life with their husband while staying home and wait for the husband to come back. Like, you know, make the food, take care of the children, all this other stuff. But during this era, women wanted to stand up for themselves and being seen as just not staying at home. They wanted to be equal as a man and have opportunities for jobs as well. That's pretty much what the feminism movement is all in a nutshell.
How is feminism portrayed in AMP? So we gathered several quotes from the stories and the video. So one of them would be, "You never know for sure how girls' mind works. Do you really think it's a mind of three or just a little buzz like it being in a desk job?" So basically, like, he's kind of asking if the girls don't have brain in their minds, like, what do we think if they don't know what they're doing? Another one would be, "Poor kids, I begin to feel sorry for them. They couldn't help it." The last one would be, "If a woman generally put on a shirt or shorts or something before they get out of their car into the street. And anyway, these are usually women with six children and varicose veins mapping their legs." So there he's judging them by what they're wearing, putting them on shame, and just like how everyone was just looking at them. And that's what caught them his attention, and how he just didn't like how people were distracted by them. So two other quotes would be, "Girls, I don't want to argue with you. After this, come in here with your shoulders covered. It's our policy." So we believe that it wasn't really their policy. He was just like so bothered how Earl was distracted by them. So he just made it up so next time they would walk in that store, they would be all covered up. "A few house babes in pink curls even looked around after pushing their carts past to make sure what they had was seen correct." So back then, like, it wasn't normal for girls to just walk in a store with a bathing suit on. So everyone was just like, "Did we just see that? Like, did that just happen?" So Queenie represents the independent woman acting equals as male. So she was basically just walking there with pride, didn't care what how people looked at her, and how she just wanted to be equal with everyone else. So we did put a little slide right here of the YouTube, so you guys can refresh.
Smoothest scoops of vanilla ice cream I've ever seen.
like as a sex, like a sex object, like he was just concentrated in her body parts and like just like judging her.
Our conclusion would be that we have seen an overview of AMP and how feminism was portrayed in the whole story. Of Life was trying to send a message to the readers that those social standards must be removed in order for the female to be free without being judged for everything they do. So basically it's like in the beginning he was judging them as well, but then towards the end when he actually sees how others saw them, he was just like, he didn't think it was right, so that's when he tried to stop him by like, don't be judging them.
Standing up for them. Like, one of the reasons he walked out was because, well, he wanted her attention, but he also saw that the man was doing wrong and the way he treated them, he wanted to talk to them. So at the end he sees like, what have I done now? Like, I'm left alone. And he's just thinking of life.